The nasal airway is held open by bone and cartilage. In this view, we can see three areas that can potentially obstruct the nasal airway and prevent normal nasal breathing. If the airway is blocked by enlarged turbinates or a deviated septum, this may be corrected with a septoplasty or a turbinate reduction. If the sidewall is collapsed, your doctor may recommend a spreader graft procedure. This means that a spacer lifts the collapsed cartilage out of the way and adds more space in the nasal cavity. If the sidewall collapse only happens when you breathe, your doctor may recommend a procedure called nasal valve stabilization. This procedure lifts the collapsed cartilage out of the way by anchoring it to the nasal bone for stability. The size and shape of the roof of your mouth, called the hard palate, is important for normal nasal breathing too, because the roof of your mouth is also the floor of the nasal cavity. A hard palate that is too narrow means less space in the nasal cavity, which makes it difficult to breathe through your nose, and less space in your mouth, which makes the tongue uncomfortably packed in. If a narrow, hard palate is the cause of your difficulty breathing, your doctor may recommend a hard palate expansion. Before the procedure, your orthodontist will attach a temporary anchorage device to your hard palate. Then, during the procedure, your surgeon will divide the hard palate. You will notice a small gap between your upper teeth. After the procedure, you can turn the anchorage device yourself to gradually expand the hard palate over the course of 1 month. Braces will gradually return the teeth to their normal location over several months, and the device can be removed. The new expanded hard palate makes more space in the nasal cavity to breathe and more space in the mouth for the tongue to rest comfortably.